our community is actually very concerned about climate change. Yakama Nation has been trying to be more proactive, trying to be on the front lines and make sure that we're doing whatever we can to prevent catastrophic failures within our management strategies.
The seasons to dig, the roots are gathered, the plants, they're getting shorter and shorter, and they're getting earlier in the year than they should be.
I have been fighting fires since 96 and have noticed a trend in fires. The seasons are longer, the fires are burning larger, more intense. It started around 2008, we had 8,000 acre fire, and those were usually only every 20 years. But then here in 08 we had one, and in 2012 we had team fire, and then 2013 we had mile marker 28 fire, 2015 we had the Cougar Creek, which was 56,000 acres. And now it's gotta be 100,000 acres before it's even considered a mega fire. Communities and people have to deal with the smoke a lot longer now. We have smoke issues from May all the way into October.
In 2015, the Cougar Creek fire was pretty devastating, and we have a youth camp in the closed area, and they were evacuated. Sometimes that's the only time them kids get outdoors in the mountains and participate in outdoor activities.
Smoke as a health impact is a big one. We have a lot of elders with asthma and COPD. We have a lot of kids with asthma and allergies already. It's one of those impacts where we're trying to work with our Indian Health Service and our local medical facilities to figure out ways that we can best help our communities and, you know, keep people safe.
The Yakama Nation have been out trying to help educate communities and letting them know things that they can do to help make their land and adjacent properties fire resistant. Funding and resources have been down on a downward slide in the last 20 years. And so with fewer resources, it makes it more difficult to suppress fires. We just need to be better prepared for dealing with the smoke and working together to try to have a fire resilient community and working on good forest management and try to minimize impacts for when it is a large fire season.
The real question is like, okay, we know the fires are coming. What are we going to be able to do after those fires to make sure these areas are still here for our children and grandchildren to use?